All right. Happy Sunday, families. I am so excited to welcome you and your scholars back tomorrow. And I wanted to make sure that we could just connect briefly today so that you feel like you've got all the information needed for a successful first day. So just wanted to start by letting you know that we are so ready for tomorrow and so excited to see all of our scholars in person. At our community conversation last week, many of you asked to see pictures of the building, pictures of the school, what is it gonna look like? And so wanted to start by just sharing some highlights of our building readiness for you. You've got your seventh grade math team in their classroom, getting their welcome message ready. You've got an incredible fifth grade peace place over here for a mask break and just a moment of zen. We've got some really amazing bulletin boards done by our teachers, sixth grade ELA reading bulletin board, really taking the cake here along with celebrating women in STEM for eighth grade science. So just wanted to give you a peek inside our doors so you know what your scholars are gonna see when they arrive tomorrow. Also just wanted to share, highlight some of the COVID safety photos. So we talked at our community conversation around social distancing measures that are put in place. The first photo here you can see, scholars are, they have sneeze guards attached to each individual desk. The pods of desks are clustered so that scholar chairs are 3 feet from one another, but those added safety measures of screen guards on all desks and masks along with proper ventilation in our rooms is going to ensure that we are keeping our scholars and our staff as safe as possible. In the middle, you'll see an example of some of the signage that is posted all throughout our building, reminding scholars and staff to keep 3 feet distance whenever possible, to stay home if they're sick, make sure they're wearing a mask and washing their hands, and to avoid touching their face. And then in the far right, you'll see just an example of the operation station with extra PPE that's available in every classroom. So there are sanitizing wipes, there is air sanitizer, there are extra masks, extra hand sanitizer, paper towels, everything that students and staff are gonna need to keep our classroom spaces clean and our scholars safe while we return to school. So wanted to just start by sharing those visuals with you. Some reminders for tomorrow. These are things that you need to do before arriving to school. So we are going to continue to fill out our health screener and be ready to show that green check. That can be on your phone. It can be on your scholar's device if she is bringing a device with her. Some families printed it off, but hopefully being able to show it on a device is a little easier for you in the morning. You'll receive the link to the health screener via text message through Kinvo in the morning every day. There will also be URL codes posted outside of school if you need them. You can scan the URL code with your the camera on your cell phone and you'll be able to fill out the health screener that way. Again, if there is for some reason you don't receive the text through Kinvo. Make sure that you have sent your scholar's negative COVID test result to girlspreplesms@girlsprep.org. You can also bring a hard copy if that's easier for you. Make sure you've completed the dismissal roster update that Ms. Denolis sent out. I should have gotten that text yesterday. If you did not get it, you'll have a chance to confirm your scholar's dismissal preferences when you arrive. Make sure your scholar's supplies are packed in her book bag, including extra masks and a clear water bottle. We will have plenty of disposable masks to provide for scholars if they need them, but we do ask that you pack up to 5 cloth masks, just so students can change them out throughout the day. We're also asking you bring a clear water bottle. It can be tinted plastic, so like pink or blue, clear tinted plastic, but please make sure that we can actually see through it. I wanna make sure that we are bringing water to school and not our Arizona iced tea or our soda, because if that spills all over the floor, we've got quite a mess. Last note is just get that fresh uniform ready. We heard from a lot of you that you are feeling good to go with those uniforms from Flynn and O'Hara. There were several families that said, hey, there's a shortage. We were waiting online. We couldn't get them just yet. No need to fear. If you're working on it and the scholar does not have the uniform for tomorrow, please still come to school and just email Ms. Lopez, klopez@girlsprep.org, if you need support or if you know that those uniforms are arriving at some point this week. Please do not keep your scholar home. If they are not yet in full uniform, send her to school. We will have some uniforms on site to distribute. Again, just email Ms. Lopez if you know that you're going to need support or you know that they're not going to be here till later on this week. Upon arrival, reminders, doors will open at 8:30 a.m. Fifth and sixth grader entering through the courtyard. That is up the staircase on 11th Street. You're going to go up that staircase and turn to the right. There will be two lines, one for fifth grade, one for sixth grade. You're going to wait on that line to be checked in for the first day arrival. Seventh and eighth grade, they are lining up on 11th Street. You should look for the grade level signage that we'll have posted. Seventh graders will line up on one side, eighth grade will line up on the other, and there will be welcome tables and check-in tables right at that doorway. Please remember to socially distance. Keep 3 feet from the folks that are also lining up. And please wear your mask in line, both adults and students. We want to model that responsible behavior for all of our scholars. We encourage you to take a first day of school photo with your scholar. We will have some photo stations set up outside. We want to celebrate this exciting return to the building. We know it's been a minute, and so please take a moment to take a first day of school photo. There will be check-in tables set up for each grade level. And at those tables, we'll confirm that there's been a negative COVID test submitted and that we've got your dismissal form preference. Scholars are gonna receive a name tag to wear. It's gonna be a lanyard name tag that they'll have all week. It's gonna have their advisory and their room number. So I know a lot of folks said, when is my scholar gonna know her advisory? She'll get that tomorrow when she checks in, and she'll also receive a little welcome gift. And teachers and staff will be posted all throughout the building to show scholars the way to their classrooms. So please don't worry. I know once your scholar gets in that door, you're like, oh, is she gonna know where to go? Is she gonna get lost in the hallway? I promise you, she will not be lost in the hallway. We will have adults everywhere to make sure students get to their classrooms safely and they feel welcomed as soon as they walk in the doors. Dismissal reminders. We do have 12:30 dismissal Monday through Thursday this week. Friday, we will have a 3 p.m. dismissal as we're doing our lemonade social. But 12:30 is dismissal time Monday through Thursday. If you are coming to pick up your scholar, you will wait for them in the designated waiting areas, either in the courtyard if it's a fifth or sixth grader, or on 11th Street if it's a seventh and eighth grader. There are going to be signs posted for where you should wait for your scholars, and there will be staff members outside to assist you. Really important, whoever is picking up your scholar must be on the dismissal roster to be cleared to pick them up, and they will be asked to show ID this week as we confirm who those folks are that are allowed to pick up your scholar. So please, if it is not you, if it is someone else in the family, make sure that they're A, on the list, and B, have their ID. Once the ID has been checked, staff will release the scholar to walk over and meet you as the adult or whatever adult's picking them up to dismiss out the exit. Asking that you please do not approach the student waiting area. Really important, especially in this first week, as we are confirming who is picking up whom, that you stay in those designated waiting areas. It'll help us keep social distancing, and it will also ensure that we have a safe and orderly dismissal. I am asking for your grace and flexibility, knowing that the first few days, pickup and arrival are going to take longer than usual. It is most important that we are safe and that we are getting all of our T's crossed and I's dotted So again, please, I'm asking that you give us grace and flexibility and prepare that those two processes take a little bit longer on this first week than they normally will. Last thing is first week family communication, just what to expect this week. If you've not already received your welcome call from your point of contact, you will be getting that call on Monday. You will also have a virtual home visit scheduled so that your point of contact can just chat with you and your scholar and learn a little bit more about you as we set up that partnership for the year. There will be a Lemonade Social to meet teachers and staff Friday, September 3rd at 3 p.m. in the courtyard. If you are unable to join in person, there will also be a virtual meet and greet on Friday the 3rd at 4:30 p.m. Zoom invites will be forthcoming for that from your grade team leaders. Early morning drop-off confirmation will be emailed to families this week. Reminder that the start date for early morning drop-off is not until September 13th. So again, if you already signed up with interest for early morning drop-off, please know we will be confirming availability for your spot this week. If you have not yet signed up and you need to, please email the main office, girlsprep@girlsprep.org to sign up as soon as possible. Last thing, encourage you to join the Lower East Side Middle Community Council Facebook page. It is a private group where we share updates and information. You can post questions for other families or for our community council representatives. And you can, it's just a great way to communicate with families and also with staff. So if you've not already requested to join, please do so that you can also just be in community and communication that way. All right, families, that's it. Thank you for taking the time to listen on a Sunday. It is going to be an amazing week and an amazing year ahead. I really look forward to seeing everyone tomorrow at greeting again at 8:30. So have a great rest of your Sunday. And we'll see you soon. Take care.